My insurance to pay, get my medical expenses, the insurance, God bless you.
Okay. Yes, ma'am.
I'm just gonna office up with Hurricane Quinn. Sammy and Sarah and Tommy currently are still quarantining healthy children.
No, yeah, we don't want that. So I've said that from the very beginning. So the question is, quarantining healthy kids. No, you don't quarantine healthy kids. We've said that repeatedly. First of all, these kids are not at significant risk of this. That is very clear by now. They are not significant sources of spreading, but all the adults have access to vaccine anyways. And so healthy quarantines are not something that I think should be done. I think, honestly, it's been very unfair to a lot of people when the locals do that, because you have a kid, you take them out of school, and they're not sick. You know, it's one thing if you're sick to stay home, but to say, oh, well, you may have passed someone in the hallway, therefore you have to stay home for 2 weeks. It's hard for parents, too, because the parents have to figure out, especially our single moms, they got to juggle work now, and then they have their healthy kid is told they can't go back to school or something. So, no, we don't support healthy quarantine. Europe does not do healthy quarantine in schools. What they do is if someone has symptoms, then they have them stay home, and then they can test them. But if people are healthy, then they behave like healthy people. We also need to, you know, these kids should not be having to wear masks in these schools.
Amen.
We have to let them go to school and be like normal kids and go to school normally. That's what really the evidence has told us we need to be doing. Clearly, from an emotional, physical, psychological perspective, you know, that's obviously just a no-brainer to have them be normal. Many places in Florida have done that, and I know a lot of them are saying, well, we're definitely going to do that going forward. But I think that should be the policy statewide. And obviously, if these guys were to put something on my desk that said that, you know, I would obviously sign that without question. So we'll be happy to do it.
Common sense, Governor.
We all said, I know you said we're not here. In Santa Rosa County, especially with our Board of Education and also in Sandy, they're kind of reworking it as SEL, which is social emotional learning. And our great week-to-five summer reading books, there are several of them that are kind of about critical race theory. It's all about the race, and it's just pointing out, and it's putting, to me, it's putting in their minds the separation. So what can we do about situations like that? When you don't want that, we talk that our boards are still in the Santa Rosa Board of Education actually passed a curriculum that has that in it already.
So you know, you can put lipstick on a pig, it's still a pig. And, you know, you can rename. So what we're doing, the Florida Board of Education is meeting, and they are addressing this. And I told them they need to address this, and we've got to do it. I mean, first of all, it's offensive. Here we are celebrating tax savings. It's offensive to the taxpayer that they would be asked to fund critical race theory, that they would be asked to fund teaching kids to hate their country and to hate each other.
You got it. America's governor.
And it's also based on false history. When they try to look back and denigrate the founding fathers, denigrate the American Revolution, doing all these different things that even very liberal historians say is not supported by the facts. And so I think what we need is we need the Constitution back in classrooms. We need to make sure civics is a priority, but it needs to be taught accurately. It needs to be taught in a fact-based way, not an ideological-based way. And if we have to play whack-a-mole all over the state stopping this critical race theory, we will do it. What I would rather...
Amen, brother.
So we'll be taking action, don't you worry. Thanks, everybody. God bless you guys.
We know he will.
Thank you.